Hi everyone, Greg Wilkins back here with you with another edition of the Daily Pause, a devotional of positivity and encouragement for Saturday, January 22nd, 2022. As always, I pray that you not only have a very blessed day today, but that today's devotional will help encourage, inspire, and motivate you, as well as put a smile on your face. You can catch past episodes of the Daily Pause devotional on my YouTube channel, Greg Wilkins, or on Facebook on my page, The Daily Pause, where you can leave all your comments, your birthday shout-outs, your devotional topic requests, your song requests, and any song or video performances you would like to see as a feature part of the Daily Pause devotional. Today's devotional is entitled, When All Else Fails. About the fourth grade, my vision started to get worse. And when I mean worse, bad, very bad. I don't know if you remember those points in elementary school where you would have to get your spelling words off the board and or off the projector, and you have to carry your notebook and go sit down in front of the blackboard or sit down in front of the screen and write all your stuff. And every time something was on the board, whether it be sentences, you had the diagram, whatever was on the board, you had to go carry your notebook and go sit down in the front of the floor just to write them down. That was me. And it got progressively worse. So my mom and dad had my vision checked, and it turned out I needed glasses. So they had to wait a while because we couldn't afford to just go get glasses just like that. So around the beginning of the fifth grade, I got myself a pair of glasses. And with that pair of glasses came a backup pair, and it came in its own case, and they were pretty cool. Now my mom reminded me every single day, about 17,342 times a day, I don't care where you go, make sure you have your backup pair of glasses and your case with you just in case something happens to your glasses. Every time I head out the door, got your glasses with you? Yes, ma'am. Every time I head to school, you got your glasses with you? Yes, ma'am. Every time we went somewhere, Greg, make sure you got your glasses with you. Make sure you got your glasses with you just in case something happens. But after a while, you know how we get. We get to a point where nothing's happened yet, so we assume nothing will happen. So one day at church, it was a youth Sunday. And of course, all the youth were going to be in the choir, and we're going to sing in the choir, but we're also going to be assigned different tasks throughout the service. Someone was going to pray, someone was going to read the scripture, others would help take up offering and all types of things like that. Well, this particular youth Sunday, I was assigned to read the scripture. And when you know it, at the beginning of Sunday school, snap, my glasses snapped right in half. And of course, me being the diligent person who always obeyed his mom and dad, I brought my pair of glasses with me. No. Like I said earlier, I got to the point where I thought, these things aren't going to break. They're never going to break. So I just left them at home on my dresser. So I spent the next 35, 40 minutes in the middle of Sunday school trying to figure out how I'm going to read the scripture, either without my glasses, which was not going to happen, or trying to fit them together, trying to hold my head still. That's how crazy I was. I took the two halves, put them back on my face, and tried to hold my head still and make sure that the glasses wouldn't fall. But every time my head moved slightly, boom, they fell down, and they fell. And then I tried to use them as magnifying glasses, holding up and trying to read the scripture that way. That didn't work. I even flipped them over. Maybe they'll get bigger if I look them the other way. I tried everything I could, and everything failed. So we're leaving the Sunday school class and we're heading out to getting our positions and whatnot. And my mom says, are you ready? Where are your glasses? And I said, they're in my pocket. Well, don't you think you should put them on? Okay, so I reached in my pocket and pulled them out, and there they were in two pieces. What happened to your glasses? Said, well, in the middle of Sunday school, they broke. Well, you got your other pair with you, right? No, ma'am. I said, why don't you have them with you? I told you this might happen. Well, I didn't think it ever happened, so I just left them on my dresser. She said, all right, stay right there. I'll be right back. Fortunately, we lived about a half a mile from the church. So she jumped in the car, went in and grabbed my glasses real quick and came back, handed them to me, and we put them on, and everything else went fine. On the way home, I was expecting the beating of my life because, you know, you disobey your parents and you know you shouldn't have. Something was going to happen. So I get back home and I was just waiting for it. And my mom looked at me and she took me to the side and she said, the next time something happens, just come tell me. You sat in that Sunday school class the entire time and you knew your glasses were broken. You should have asked your teacher to go let me find my mom because my glasses broke so I can go get my other pair. The next time it happens, You need to come to me. Don't wait till the last minute. Because what if I was stuck somewhere else? What if I was making hot dogs early? Because that's what my mom did. My mom made hot dogs for the church, so we sold after church. And so what if I wasn't able to go get your glasses? What would have happened? To make sure you come to me earlier. That's what you got to do. I said, yes, ma'am. And I didn't get a beating. But I couldn't play the Nintendo for the next 2 weeks. The point of the story is that we often, I don't care how successful we are now, how successful we'll be in the future, or what we've done in our lives, there's always going to be a point in our lives in which we're going to need some help. And if we ever reach that point, like I did, like I said on break, that's when something is going to happen. We should never get to that point. We're always going to be in a position in which we need assistance. But us being human, we're going to try to figure out everything and every possible scenario for ourselves. And often at the last minute, that's when we reach out for help. But in the meantime, before we ask anybody for help, we build up the anxiety. We build up the worry. We build up the what ifs. We build up the oh no, what am I going to do? And we try to come up with every possible negative scenario. What's going to happen to me when I'm going to ask for help? Are people going to laugh at me? Am I going to be embarrassed? What's going to happen? And that's why we often don't ask for help. But the Bible reminds us in Philippians chapter 4, verses 6 through 7, be anxious for nothing, for in all things, in prayer and supplication with thanksgiving, make our requests be known unto God. And the peace of God, which passes all understanding, will keep your hearts and minds through Christ Jesus. We shouldn't have to worry about what people think. We shouldn't try to worry about being embarrassed. We shouldn't allow our pride to rise up in us and prevent us from asking for help. He told us that he would never leave us nor forsake us. And it reminds me of an old song that one of the fathers in our church, Lester Swindler, used to sing all the time. And the first line of the song says everything. If you know the Lord is keeping you, what you gotta worry about? If we know that the Lord has been our provider, if we know the Lord has been our comfort, if we know the Lord has been our peace, if we know the Lord has been our anchor, if we know the Lord has been everything and much more to us in our lives, then why are we worrying? Why are we stressing? Why are we waiting to the absolute last minute, taking on unneeded stress and unneeded pain and unneeded worry and unneeded doubt and unneeded aggravation when we know that the Lord will make a way for us? We often allow our pride to get in the way. We often rely on ourselves to think we know more than we do. We try to figure it out on our own. But it's good to know when we fall into those human lapses in our lives and we get to that point where we're trying to figure out everything on our own and it still doesn't work. And we let the doubt come in and the stress come in and the worry come in and the pride come in and all those other things. When all those things have failed, it is good to know. And it's a great relief in knowing that Jesus will not fail. He cannot fail. And he's always with us. He always will be with us. So I encourage you on today. Let's not wait to the last minute when we know we have a keeper, when we know we have a protector, and we know we have a provider. Why wait to the last minute? Let's go to Jesus up front and let's go to the throne of grace boldly and let us make our request known that he may give us grace to get us through this situation. Today's feature song is one of my top five hymns of all time. And forgive me for not knowing off the top of my head who wrote the song originally. But this arrangement of the song was arranged by Anthony Brown. And the name of the hymn is Sweet Hour of Prayer. On the album, it's called Our Prayer. And he does the first verse. And the first verse goes like this. Sweet hour of prayer, sweet hour of prayer that calls me from a world of care and bids me at thy Father's throne make all my wants and wishes known. In seasons of distress and grief, my soul often finds sweet relief and oft escape the tempter's snare by thy return, sweet hour of prayer. It's not very long, it's about 2.5 minutes long, and it's a beautiful arrangement, and it just reminds us, one, the importance of prayer, the importance of communication of God, and two, when we think we're at our wit's end, we can go to our Father. We can go to him in prayer. And he'll make our wishes and he'll grant our requests. If we just hold on by faith and trust that God will make a way, he'll take us from this this world of care and all the worry and down doubt and all the grief that we brought upon ourselves by trying to do it on our own. And he'll give us that way of escape, and he'll give us that peace that surpasses all understanding in the process. So I hope you're blessed by this devotional. I hope you'll be blessed by the song coming up in a couple of minutes. And I hope you remain encouraged that no matter what you go through, when all else fails, Jesus won't, and he'll meet you at your need. Let's pray. Father God, we thank you for your grace and your mercy. Lord, we thank you for being by our side every step of the way. When we stumble and fall, you're there to pick us up. When we get too boastful and braggadocious about ourselves and think we're smarter than we should be, you're there to wipe off the dust and to pick us up and to encourage us and to help us move forward and forgetting the mistakes we made. We grow from our mistakes and we mature from our mistakes thanks to your peace, your love, and your understanding. And we thank you for keeping us and protecting us at all times. And we will thank you and praise you every step of the way for who you are to us. In Jesus' name, amen. Before we go, we always do our birthday shout outs. And today, we want to wish happy birthday to April Johnson. Happy birthday to Robin Dorman, one of my college classmates. Hope you're doing well, sir. Happy birthday to one of my mentors, one of the people I looked up in high school and in college, Ben Robinson, and happy birthday to Joseph Drabaloff. And Joseph, thank you for your service in the military. Joseph, April, Robin, and Ben, I hope you all have a very blessed birthday, and may God bless you with many more. That's going to do it for today's edition of The Daily Pause. I hope you're blessed, I hope you're encouraged, and I hope you enjoyed today's feature song, Our Prayer, based off the hymn, Sweet Hour of Prayer, arranged by Anthony Brown and performed by Anthony Brown and Group Therapy off the album Second Wind Ready, released in 2019 by Frere Trade Services, Key of A Music, and Tisket Records. Continue to love each other, continue to be safe, and remember, every day is always time to take a pause. And Lord willing, I'll see you again on tomorrow, forgive me for that. Special shout out to the background music, I'm Encouraged by Thomas Whitfield, performed by Darius Witherspoon. Today's feature song starts right now. Take care, and remember, there's no need to carry around unneeded stress, burdens, and grief. Take it to the Lord in prayer. He'll meet you at your need. God bless. Thank you.